am Tanya Memme, and we're about to start the roundtable for Focus Magazine. And this is the issue all about home, home design, design trends, and home everything. I was the host of A&E's Sell This House Extreme, Move This House for 13 years, and now I'm on Home and Family, and I am a mommy DIY expert, lifestyle expert on the show on Hallmark Channel. So that's me, and now let's go around the table. We'll start with you, Andrea. Tell us a little bit about yourself.
I'm Andrea Schroder, and I'm an interior designer, and I have a fragrance, home fragrance company. I make candles and room sprays and lotions and soaps, and they're available at Nordstrom's and Hallmark and all kinds of other stores across the country, and I'm a mother of four and a wife and a friend.
That you are. Anne, what about you?
Hi, I'm Anne Stedman-Herwick, and I have a blog called Chic Mom LA, which we speak everything chic. And then I'm also a wife and a mother of two. And
a friend.
A friend. I like to think of myself as a friend.
Yes. I'm Heather Bilyeu. I'm a real estate agent. I've been selling real estate for 11 years now. Started in Las Vegas and now in Los Angeles. And I'm also on a show, Bravo's Million Dollar Listing. And I'm engaged with two little dogs.
Yay. Well, I forgot to say I have a three-year-old too, Ava. And she's on Home and Family all the time. Okay, there you go.
I have a niece and nephew. My name's Jackie Gunn, and I'm a real estate agent. I work at Partners Trust. I'm an investor, and I help clients flip properties.
And I'm Monty Beisel. Work with Hilton Highland. I do real estate development throughout Los Angeles. And played former NFL football player / interior designer.
Hey! Whoa. Nice!
Good combo.
Okay, so the first thing I want to ask you guys is, where do you live and why do you love the area that you live in?
Sure. I live mostly in Topanga Canyon, which is like a really hippie, chic neighborhood. There's all kinds of artists and musicians, so if you don't have to commute to downtown, it's a great place, and it seems to be up and coming with real estate. There's a lot of new hippies moving in there. It's fun because we have like a farm in the middle of LA. We have donkeys and chickens.
Oh, right away.
I grow like all my own herbs for my products. And so it's like really like a weird contrast that within LA, which is such this vibrant artistic city, you can also live on a farm right in the middle of it.
So, and you have your own bees too. So you make your own honey.
Yeah, we have our own bees. We make honey. Goodness. And we're right in LA.
It's incredible.
And it's also like affordable land, which is surprising to think that you could have land in LA. So I think that would surprise people to know that Topanga Canyon is like in the heart of LA. With acreage.
So. And how far are you from downtown? Just to give us a...
I can be in LAX in 20 minutes. No traffic.
Nice! Wow.
I live in Toluca Lake. We just sold and just moved into another house in Toluca Lake because we love it so much. And what I love about it being from Texas is there's cul-de-sacs. There's like sidewalks on both sides of the street. My two children can ride their bikes. You feel really safe. And it's, for the most part, all the highways are around Toluca Lake.
Yeah. So it's easy access.
Yes.
There's some nice shops there, too.
There are great some amazing shopping. Shops. Yes. It's become very trendy lately, which
very
I'm
hip and
very
trendy.
Excited about.
Which you've been writing and blogging
yes,
a lot
I've been
about.
Yes, blogging like crazy about it.
Okay, so Heather, what about yourself?
I live in the Birch Streets in the hills. I love it. I used to live in the flats of West Hollywood.
Uh-huh.
But we decided to try the hills. And I think it's great because I get the city view. You're kind of removed from the craziness. But when you want to go down to it, it's just a 3-minute ride down to, Sunset Boulevard and all the hot spots and trendy restaurants and people watching, which I love to do. But the homes are amazing in the hills.
And they're also very private up there, too.
Very, very private, which you don't necessarily expect. But I also like it because I can go hiking with the dogs up into the hills. And
that's true.
Yeah, I love it. It's great. A view from my master bedroom looking over the twinkling lights, so can't complain. Nice
gorgeous.
Glass of wine.
Nice. Okay, what about yourself?
Well, I live in Beverly Hills, and gosh, I love it because it's so vibrant and there's so many different cultures coming together. It's very, I don't know, it's very positive and has a good vibe to it. But for me, I think that I actually like going to places that are just getting gentrified because I love checking out, like, there's some, like, cool little eclectic shop and it has something that's interesting about it that no one else knows, and I feel like I'm discovering something new in LA. So for me, it's all about the discovery.
If you could choose your favorite spot to live, where would that be?
I would choose possibly Nichols Canyon just because I feel like it's so private and I love the hustle and bustle of the city, but I'm a country girl at heart. I'm right. from Mount Baldy, so I want to go back up there and kind of be around green and have, I don't know, maybe one day I'll get like chickens or something.
And I go get chickens. Like Andrea does in Topanga.
Oh, you do?
And Monty, what about yourself?
I currently live in Encino Hills.
Oh, okay.
Originally, when I moved to LA, I lived in West Hollywood as well, as like most people do when they first move to LA. I built a house up in Encino Hills in 2005. Lived there ever since. I love it. I feel like I'm, like everyone here, I feel like I'm centralized to everything. I kind of get everywhere. I kind of use my Holland as my back door into Hollywood.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's more neighborhood friendly as far as families go.
That's true.
I live on a cul-de-sac. It's a little bit wider streets. It's not so narrow passages. And, yeah, I love it. That's what's cool about LA, I guess, is it, everyone kind of has their own eclectic little area that they love, and everyone's there's a little something for everybody.
Okay, so what I want to know is, most of you guys are totally into design. How, what's your design theme in your house? I mean, I know, Andrew, this is your beach house. You have your place in Topanga. Tell me a little bit about the design of your house and why you chose that.
Here?
Either one, this one or the one in Topanga.
I mean, I always design around lifestyle because I have kids and a family, and we have animals, and so... And I also design around like the vibe that I want people to have. So I want my house to reflect me and what I love.
The one thing I noticed about your house, I mean, aside from many things, because I have been to your house in Topanga, is that there's little, every corner and every nook and cranny has a story. Like, you really designed it that way. And you have this wall, she has a wall of photos of her family, and each of them is a moment. It's not just a, you know, a photo. it's an emotional moment captured. Yeah. And then there's the kids' artwork that's framed along with it. And it's this, and it has love. You have some inspirational, beautiful word there, words of, and.
Well, our homes is like our first classroom. And so I'm just like super passionate about the home and the vibe that we have in the home. And so it's more, design is like really about reflecting who lives there and how people feel when they're in your house.
All right, so let's bring it over here. Monty, what about you? What does your house look like?
I'm a little more Spanish contemporary.
Okay.
Yeah. I like clean lines as well, and very hard, dark hardwood floors. Love dark wood, but just clean lines, open, lots of light. You know, floor to ceiling glass as much as possible. And
did you design your home?
I did, and that's one thing about I think myself is I've always been very particular with how I want to live and where I want to live. And so when it came time to purchase a home, I was basically ready to tear it down to the studs and start over because I wanted exactly what I wanted. Otherwise, I would feel like I'm living in someone else's home. And so I did that. And, you know, I love it. I love the indoor-outdoor vibe. I think that's huge in California. A lot of people are doing that. And like you said, the reclaimed wood right now is huge for a lot of clients that we work with. It's how can we incorporate reclaimed wood throughout the house, be eco-friendly, and yet have a modern, stark kind of feel that we want.
Nice. So. And what about you, Jeff?
Inside my home?
Yeah. What style did you go with in your home? And did you design it?
I did. Well, I basically had a moment where I came into my house and I said, I don't like anything about it. And I went to clean. And I used this, it's a Spanish 1920s little bungalow. So I used the bones of it, and I wanted it to not be kind of this, everyone's doing this thing where it looks like they've like injected saline solution and it kind of looks like a little bit bloated and it's like poofy. So I wanted it to maintain the clean lines and be very delicate and sophisticated. So I took pieces from the 1920s that I found in stores for kind of a discount, and I wanted to do it on a really extreme budget. So the floors are all something that are from the typical era. So they're the little hex pattern or something like that.
I love that.
Yeah. Or else like the lamps are something that has a modern twist to something you would find in the 20s Art Deco. I wanted to just kind of modernize what I had, and that's what I did. I think the one thing that people in California do is they find something old and they want to make it new, and so they put in everything that's new right now, and they lose the authenticity of something. And I really think it's a shame because the 1920s were such a beautiful time.
All right.
I'm just the opposite of you. I live in a brand new modern home, so I wanted to make it feel more inviting and warm. And kind of soften those hard lines. So I have a lot of like textures in my house. So I've got the bifold glass doors from floor to ceiling, and a lot of concrete and metal. So I brought in a lot of natural woods with my furniture. So like our dining room table is a raw natural piece of wood, and lots of whites because I knew this is the last time I'm ever going to be able to have white furniture before I have children.
I have white furniture. Yeah, and I have two boys.
But you can
just
There's a slip cover. Yeah. Everything is slip cover.
Yeah, no, it was my dream to have white furniture at least once in my life. So it's very clean, and I love that. But then we also have amazing art to bring in, like a pop of color. Mm-hmm. We also have a lot of vintage pieces. Like we have a cigarette machine from probably the 50s, I think, just to add some.
Do you guys smoke?
No.
Didn't think so.
No, don't smoke. But I guess that's why we want to be cool and act like we smoke, but we don't.
So Anne, what about your house?
So our new house is very open, which I needed for the boys, you know? So, and then we have the dark floors, and it is modern furniture, but I kind of warmed it up with antiques as well. So, because sometimes modern can be so harsh and not welcoming. So, and I got rid of about half of my furniture. So I'm so excited to start over, like what we were talking about. And I'm kind of like right now doing a little research and then deciding. But yeah, I'm very, very excited.
I like that.
Yeah.
Okay, the first part of the area of LA that comes to your mind, we're not going to discuss it. I just want to know what comes to your mind. What do you think is the hottest, trendiest area in LA to live right now, Andrea?
Well, from the traffic outside of my house, I'd say Malibu.
No.
And what
I would say the Valley is becoming hip and trendy, you know, and everyone's starting to move out there. I lived in West Hollywood, and as soon as I had my son, I needed more room and more land for families.
What do you think, Heather?
I see a lot of people going to Truesdale Estates. That's, you've got wide streets, flat lots, so you can have a gorgeous single level home.
Jetliner views sometimes.
Yeah, exactly. Cool, no. And the mid-century homes that are being redone, and they're gorgeous and stunning.
Wow.
Like,
I
they're
didn't
so
know
your
that.
Style. Yeah, teardowns are starting at $4.5 million there.
That's
so the
problem.
So they are.
No problem. Yeah.
I think as far as what we see a lot is development side. I mean, like Heather alluded to, is Hollywood Hills, Truesdale area, Bird Streets. Mm. I mean, you drive up there right now, it's every third house is up there is being redone.
Mm-hmm. What type of house is in right now? Like, what are people sort of going?
Mid-century, totally.
Mid-century,
yeah,
just
and
the
it,
one?
It has the simplest lines out of any of the designed homes. Like, traditional layout is very compartmentalized. You have a formal dining room, you have a butler's pantry, but then when you have the mid-century, it's all open, like what everyone wants. So you could blow out one wall from the kitchen to the family room, and boom, you've got California lifestyle. Everyone wants that indoor-outdoor
feel. I feel like Cape Cod is also becoming quite popular.
On the west side particularly.
Yeah.
West side is like, think about different neighborhoods, and I think about cocktails and drinks. And like, west side is very like spa water. Everything is clean and fresh and, I don't know.
It's a good way to put it.
Spa water.
It is.
Spa water.
I love it. Like,
as you come in.
And Lululemon.
Okay, so what is the difference between designing your house to sell it as opposed to living in it? Because I know there's a big difference.
I'll say, since we just sold our house, is getting rid of the clutter and making it as simple as possible so people can see their own personality into the house. And we sold our house in 10 hours. So,
let's go
there!
That's an LA trend.
There you go.
Price to sell.
I was like, let's do this. So
you have to be very careful with how custom you go and how particular you go with
when you're selling it.
Yeah. Well, if you're building for yourself or doing a remodel, think of how to appeal to the masses. Unfortunately, you know, don't do a purple granite or something. Mm-hmm. You need to stay a little more neutral. And don't get rid of bathrooms. I hate when people do that. Bathrooms are a big key seller.
They are.
And it's so expensive to put a bathroom back in. So just keeping it more simple and neutral when you're doing a remodel.
Okay.
And the same goes for outside your landscaping. The more yard you have in the backyard, the more your eye can just like go out, the better. So. And don't be afraid for a real estate agent to tell you, I'm so sorry, but we need to stage, just because your furniture might be very specific to you going on the specific thing.
Mm-hmm.
But then if someone comes in and they say, well, an interior designer could put a white couch in, a white couch really opens up the room and it doesn't feel so small and tight and closed off. So there's certain choices you can put into a home which trick your eye. So don't be offended, I guess, is another
thing. I also think like light walls when you go in and
gallery.
It's so dark.
Yes. I just did that.
White.
Me too.
I just did that on a listing that I have. It was Mediterranean, and I made them paint the house white outside and inside.
Smart.
So
good job,
it's
girl.
Opened it up, and it allows the buyer to come in and really kind of have a fresh palate and be able to do whatever they want. You know,
clean slate is so important.
Monty, what do you think?
I mean, I agree with everything you guys are saying. To me, the first initial presentation is through photos and how you represent the
home.
Make
sure they're stellar photos.
When you have buyers looking at homes, I mean, it's literally like, you know, it's like you're, it's like Match.com or Tinder or whatever. And they're just flipping through pictures.
But
and if they don't
true,
like
though.
The initial picture they see, they just go to the next one.
Yeah.
Right. But
yeah.
having something they can see and relate to right away and they like it,
yeah.
if I can just get them in the door,
right.
then I can sell something.
That's
but
like
if I
really
can't get them in the door,
exactly. That's the call I just,
right now,
that's
right?
the call I just made. I was like, don't shoot the living room without
Absolutely.
Me because I need to be there to put the furniture the right way. Otherwise, it's
a
horrible.
Yeah, I agree.
I want to control all the photos. I got, you know, be there, stage everything.
90% of your buyers look online first.
Yeah.
And so if you don't capture them within that first photo, you lost them.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
what people don't really realize is that all of us in our jobs, we're not only just doing contracts and doing showings or putting a lockbox on a property. We're there every step of the way. It's down to like the pillow and helping with your wall color. So
yeah.
It's just
well, I hosted a show, Sell This House, on A&E, as I said before, and we shot over 350 episodes.
Oh,
so I've been in almost every house across
Holy
this
moly.
Country, staging houses to sell them, and on a budget between $500 and $1,000.
Maybe
okay.
we'll bring you in as our expert.
Right.
Now.
Right. But I have to say, the biggest mistake people made is that they didn't emotionally detach themselves from their house.
Yeah.
If you don't emotionally detach yourself from the situation, you're never going to be able to sell it and stage it properly.
Right. And then I say, like, one last tip is, like, to put an emotional buy in there. Like, get, like, a gorgeous chandelier. So, because sometimes people, like, I had some friends that were looking at, like, a multi-million dollar house based on a built-in desk.
Amazing.
They're like, it has the greatest built-in desk.
That happens all the time.
I can build that desk
really?
For you. And, yeah, and so if you have something that, like, catches somebody emotionally, I say it's, like, a gorgeous fridge or beautiful chandelier. Like, that can sell. People will emotionally connect to that, and they'll do, people, you know, it's almost like, drugged. Like,
but you don't know what. So how do you know what that thing
above.
Is? Like you
like,
said,
no. For me, it's weird. I've shown. I've had guys buy $3 million houses based on a television that was in a perfect room. It was right side, and they're like, "Oh my god!"
Right.
That's
and
amazing.
They want the television.
All
I'm like,
want.
"That's a $2,000 television you're
like,
buying."
Okay.
Sure.
Okay.
Exactly.
So when you guys are staging houses and you're helping clients, what are some of your favorite stores to go buy things to set up a house or stage a house, or even just where do you buy your favorite things for your home?
Well, I use Big Daddy Antiques a lot. Do you guys
go
there?
Oh,
yeah.
We love them.
Big Daddy.
I personally like HD Buttercup.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you go there and kind of hit all the designers.
Yeah,
a lot of designers
incredible.
In town in one shot.
I know for my kids' rooms, I don't want to spend too much because they're both boys and they get really rowdy. But, like, I love CB2 for my kids' room. And also All Modern is really great.
Yeah.
And, like, design within reach. So it's not too expensive. But the kids' rooms look really, really great.
We have fun doing flea markets, surprisingly, when I do have my fiancé, when he has patience to go do it. We find crazy things. We have a bomb that we turned into. We had it put into our front yard and turn it into a fire feature. So when you walk
Talk
in, there's, fire that comes out. Yeah. Oh, no. It's crazy. Or... like the vintage cigarette machine, we turn that into a shelf for our audio equipment.
So do you do a lot of upcycling? And
yeah, I mean, I always bring my brother-in-law with, Matt. He's got a great eye for that, and so it's a family affair then. It's fun.
Good. Well, I have to say, I learned a lot at this roundtable. I hope you guys did. It was super fun, and thanks for all of your tips and all the information.
And thank you for having us
really
in your
great.
Home.
Yes,
yeah.
thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you, Andrea,
let's go
so much.
Let's do a project together.
Okay,
yeah.
Let's go through it.
Let's do it.
Thank you.
And you've actually turned Ricky's bathroom into a man cave, which I love.
Yeah. I know, they said his and hers bathrooms are out. I'm like, it's not out for me.
That was obviously a single person that said that, because
exactly.
that's the secret to a happy
right.
relationship.
I agree.
I'm surprisingly seeing the wet bars come back a lot too.
I've
and, like,
got
the new construction.
We had a designer
nice.
Come in to make it, and it was amazing.
And you
loved
it.
We loved it a little too much, you know. And I love going to Silver Lake and feeling a little artsy, you know.
Yeah.
Why not?
So one day I'm feeling like I want to be like a chic mama. I want to go to Toluca Lake, you know. So,